Major South Korean firms launched a consultative body to help create a hydrogen power value chain. Discussions were held on the sidelines of the H2 Mobility+Energy Show. Eum Ji-young was there to file this report.
An air-purifying hydrogen fuel tram that can carry 100 people at once. A mobile hydrogen refueling station that can be used in remote areas. A hydrogen-powered car that can recognize a driver's voice and change the position of the steering wheel. Visitors encountered all these at South Korea's hydrogen industry exhibition, the H2 Mobility+Energy Show. This is the second year that the event is being held, and more than 150 companies and research institutions from 12 countries are showcasing their latest hydrogen technologies.
As many companies from home and abroad gather at this event to share their technologies and meet new business partners, I believe it can be a growth engine for the hydrogen industry and help tackle climate change.
Hyundai Motor Group revealed its first prototype of a hydrogen-powered hybrid sports car called the Vision FK, which can go from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in just 4 seconds. Hyundai also unveiled a new container transport vehicle called e-bogey trailer drone.
Unlike conventional cargo trucks, the trailer drone is powered by a hydrogen fuel cell that only emits pure water as a byproduct.
Also on the sidelines, leaders of 15 major groups involved in the sector, including Hyundai Motor Chairman Jeong Hui-sun and SK Group Chairman Choi Tae-won, gathered for the Korea H2 Business Summit. The new body aims to stimulate investment in the hydrogen sector and help Korea go carbon neutral. 5 conglomerates, including Hyundai, SK and POSCO, pledged to invest over $37 billion into hydrogen by 2030. Some SMEs said financial assistance from the government would also help develop the industry.
We always say to the government officials that it will be always great to have a lower price, maybe some subsidiaries for the electricity price so that the green hydrogen price can go down.
South Korea's Presidential Committee on Carbon Neutrality planned to come up with a detailed roadmap in October on going carbon neutral by 2050. Eum Ji-young, Arirang News.